Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. Title of our product is Analysis and Design of the Classical Complementary Metal Oxide Semiconductor Schmitt Trigger in Subthreshold Operation. Abstract of our product is the classical CMOS Schmitt Trigger operating in the subthreshold regime is designed and analyzed. The complete DC voltage transfer characteristic of the CMOS Schmitt Trigger is determined in this process. The metastable segment of the characteristic is explained in terms of the negative resistance of the NMOS and PMOS subcircuit in Schmitt Trigger. The small signal analysis is carried out to determine the minimum supply voltage at which the hysteresis appears and to obtain the rough estimation of the hysteresis width. Even though the standard CMOS circuit have been extremely analyzed in the weak invention operation, the AC gain of the Schmitt trigger is derived by substituting each MOSFET with its equivalent small signal model of the three voltage controlled current sources. These all CMOS process can be implemented by using the 180nm CMOS technology. Now we are going to discuss about the flow diagram of our product. In our product, we can implement the Schmitt trigger design using the complementary metal oxide semiconductor device, that means CMOS device. The CMOS is a combination of PMOS and NMOS devices. In our process, Schmitt trigger circuit will be implemented by using a 60 concept can be implemented by using the 6 different transistor, the combination of PMOS and NMOS transistors. In our Schmitt trigger circuit can be made by the combination of PMOS and NMOS devices. The 3 devices of transistor can be made of PMOS device, and another 3-ohm transistor is made from the NMOS device. They can be splitted into the PMOS network and the NMOS network. The positive supply voltage can be applied into the PMOS network. Similarly, the grounded supply or negative voltage supply can be applied directly into the NMOS network. The final output can be come from the combination of PMOS and NMOS network with the connection of the load capacitance. These load capacitance act as a filter. In order to reduce the noise in the output triggered pulse, we are using the load capacitance for low pass filter operations. The output signal of the PMOS network can be pulse waveform. Similarly, the output signal of the NMOS network can be made with the Z-shaped pulse waveform output signal. Now we are going to discuss about the running procedure of our product. Our product can be implemented by using the Tanner EDA 13.0 version tool. Now double click to open the tool window to create a new project using this file menu. File, new design. In order to assign the design name in the desired path using the create in folder option. After creating the project, now add the library files using this add option. Click add to select the library files. From the libraries, documents, Tanner EDA, Tanner tools, libraries, all. In order to open the all schematic component using this all library, click all to open the all file. After open the all files, now we can see the component of our product. In logic gates, they contain a buffer, D flip-flop, inverter, MUX and NAND gates. In next component is a spice element. Spice element contain a voltage sources and etc. Devices include the diode, inductor, PMOS, NMOS and capacitors and etc. MISC is used for the power supply units. Ground, VDD, VSS, etc. Spice command is act as a probe of the module. They can be connected at the end node using this print voltage and print power, print noise to print the noise power voltage of the our operating node. After adding the library files, now create a new cell using cell option. Cell new to create a new cell. In order to assign the desired cell name using this cell 0, after apply the cell name, click OK to continue our design. In our product, we are using three different cell modules to implement the design of final schemic trigger circuit. First one is 60 schemic trigger circuit. This is a combination of six different transistors with the instance of PMOS and NMOS components. And next one is a schemic trigger NMOS network, and another one is a schemic trigger PMOS network. The schemic trigger NMOS network contain only the NMOS device. Schemic trigger PMOS device contain only the PMOS device. Select the 60 schemic trigger in order to run this design using this setup simulation to assign the library files and transient and Fourier time analysis for the start time stop time of the waveform generation. After assigning the start time stop time, click OK to start simulation. This is the output waveform of 60 schemic trigger operation. In order to expand this output waveform using expand chart option, this sine wave is an input. This sine wave can be converted into pulse signal in the schemic trigger circuit. Similarly, select the second one module, start the simulation using start simulation option. This is the output waveform of schemic trigger NMOS network. In order to expand this waveform using expand chart option, this sine wave is an input signal of the schemic trigger NMOS network. This Z waveform generation is the output of the NMOS network signal. Similarly, run the PMOS network of schemic trigger design. Select the PMOS and start simulation using the start simulation option. In schemic trigger PMOS network, the output waveform contains the above the sine wave. Similarly, the schemic trigger NMOS output will be contained the below the input sine waveform. Expand this waveform using expand chart option. In this PMOS network, the input sine waves can be divided into the pulse width operation of PWM module operation. Each sine wave rising edges change into the pulse waveform. Thank you for watching this video.